Legend of Thunder. Legend of Thunder.
Noobs hit the floor when they hear that thunder roar.
Damn, bitch.
Legend of Thunder. Legend of Thunder.
Louder than Thor. Can you hear that thunder roar?
Legend of Thunder. Legend of Thunder.
All right, everybody, what's up? It's Thunder, welcome back. And on today's episode, I want to talk about some breaking news that came out this morning. Kotaku.com, a lot of you guys might be familiar with this website, maybe some of you aren't. I'm going to link all of this in the description, this whole article, you can go and read it for yourself. But a whole shitload of MW3 information came out today. And Kotaku says that they know about some perks, they know about some kill streaks. So before we get into that, first I want to read this right here. This is taken right from the article. Let's see, where is it? Oh, here it is. Key to the multiplayer experience in Modern Warfare 3 will be the ability for players to level up their characters and unlock perks to modify the effectiveness of their equipment, character, and enemy equipment. So that pretty much means there's going to be a rank-up system to get the perks. I don't think you're going to be able to buy stuff like you did in Blops. So, you know, you can't be a level 5 or 6 and already have Ghost bought or whatever. So that'll be cool. It looks like it's going to be the old Call of Duty standard rank-up system. I like that. I hope they bring that back. I love the headshot. Headshot kills for unlocking camos. The buying stuff, I don't know. You guys might like the buying perks. I like getting them through ranking up. I like that, but you know, everyone's different, and that's all I'm gonna say about that. Perks. Okay, so in the article they have this right here: the biggest new addition to the game that what we've heard of so far is the creation of team perks. These are perks that a team can work toward to earn. It is unclear whether this will be tied to clans or some other team system, but their inclusion could help push the game into a more team-driven title, something the Premium Elite service is likely to tie into. While we don't know the total number of team perks coming to Modern Warfare 3, we have been told of 4 of them, and they have Blast Shield, Health Regen, Stun Protection, and ta-da! Stopping Power! And these are all team perks. Now, we all know what Stopping Power is. Increased bullet damage, Blast Shield, we all know what that's going to do. Protect you from explosives. Health Regen, regenerate health over time, and Stun Protection, prevent stunning from flashbang grenades. Those are the team perks that Kotaku has listed that's going to be in MW3. Now, these are the regular perks coming to Modern Warfare 3, guys. Blind Eye, which will make you immune to computer-controlled and player-controlled killstreaks. The pro version make your launchers lock on faster and gives you extra bullet damage to vehicles. The next perk is Assassin. This perk makes you immune to UAV, thermal, and heartbeat sensor. The pro version also makes you immune to counter UAV, EMP, and no longer shows your name in red crosshair when you're being targeted. So basically, like I've been saying all along, all you Black Ops fans out there, Ghost Pro is so overpowered that in MW3 they actually had to break it up and divide it into 2 separate perks. Blind Eye, which is the one that pretty much makes you immune to all the kill streaks, and Assassin, which is going to make you immune to, you know, UAV, thermal, and heartbeat sensor. And then the pro version of Assassin is going to make you immune to the counter UAV and the EMP, and no crosshair when targeted. So there you go, pretty much it's Ghost Pro if you combine the Blind Eye and the Assassin. Few extra abilities granted in the pro variant, but whatever. Then the next 3 perks, we've got Point Guard, which is something I suggested a few commentaries back, if you guys remember, when I talked about assists. What Point Guard does is every 2 assists, it count towards a kill streak. I said that. I said they should make that a perk, if you guys remember. They got Dead Silence coming back, Recon, which gives a special kind of radar to spot enemies, most likely. We're not sure on this one. But those are some of the perks. Now, after this was released on Kotaku, Robert Bowling came on Twitter, 402 himself, and said that a lot of the reports that have been released on MW3 as fact are actually false. And then he went on to say, Stopping Power is not coming back. So, 402 confirmed that Stopping Power is not going to be back in MW3, and when I read that, man, my heart just sank, because I know that Modern Warfare 3 is probably just going to be another Black Ops, where you got everyone, you know, huge maps, There's no stopping power, there's no juggernaut, you know, perks designed for rushing and being aggressive. Instead, you've got perks like Blind Eye and Assassin, you know, which are basically, I don't want to say bitch perks, but they definitely don't promote aggressive gameplay. Oh, man, and that's the last thing we need, guys. I can't take another Black Ops. I can't, I mean, I can't even play Black Ops now. Like, I'll go to get my Black Ops disc to put it in my Xbox. Like, my hand will start trembling. My eyes will start twitching. I break out in cold sweats. I just can't do it, man. I can't play this game anymore. I can't even imagine another Black Ops coming out. I mean, so anyway, those were the perks. And, I mean, like I said, guys, this is just what Kotaku is reporting. This has not been confirmed by Sledgehammer or Infinity Ward or Raven, so maybe this whole list I just read to you, maybe this whole article is bogus. I mean, Robert Bowling already debunked stopping power. Who knows how many of these other perks aren't true, but I mean, the whole Blind Eye and Assassin thing, that's good. I mean, at least taking Ghost Pro and splitting it up in two, because, I mean, if you could combine both of these perks, Blind Eye and Assassin, which is basically what Ghost Pro is, I mean, we've all seen what it does. It's just bad. It's completely overpowered. So, and we've got some kill streaks here that Kotaku is reporting, EMP grenade, Little Bird, basically pretty much the kill streaks from Homefront. So, precision airstrike, stealth bomber, remote turret, directional UAV, remote mortar, airdrop trap, which you could call in an already booby trapped airdrop. That's pretty cool. You don't have to hack it. Ammo resupply, escorted airdrop, a protected airdrop. Yeah, I don't think I'll be using that. It seems pretty useless. Specialist strike package. This one remains a mystery to us, is the description. So, like I said, guys, I'm going to put this article in the description. You guys can check it out, read it for yourself. You know, take everything with a grain of salt. This is not officially released information from the actual game developer. This is just something that Kotaku, a pretty well-respected... They're pretty well-respected website, so I don't know what they'd have to gain by reporting bogus information, but these are the alleged perks, guys. Everything I just said, it's not fact, it's all been alleged. Some of it looks legit. Stopping power has already been debunked, sorry to say. So, I don't know. I'll put the link in the description, guys. Go check it out for yourself. Is this shit legit or what? Let me know what you think. It's your boy Thunder, and I'll get back to you when I know more. Talk to you later, guys. Peace!